Here in IDEF 2017, we also display a kit, which will be also in the serial production contract. It's the name of the tank is Altay AHT, which we call it asymmetrical warfare tank in Turkish, or it is a urban survival kit. So in this tank that you will see, we have lots of different kits around the existing Altay for operating in a different scenarios, especially in urban environments. These are for protection, survival, and detection, like jammers, soft kill mechanisms, electro-optical kits, to have a higher survivability in asymmetric warfare. What you see in this Altay variant is a kit fitted to existing Altay for urban survival. From front to rear, there is a dozer blade, which is controlled by a joystick from the driver's side, which can do lots of different movements for trench or closing a trench, opening an artificial trench for himself or for any requirement in urban environment. Going from back, from front to rear, all side skirts are with heavy explosive ERA, explosive armor, which can defeat a wide variety of anti-tank missiles in all sites. So it provides a 360 degrees protection with very high threat levels. On top of the turret, you can see a big electro-optical mast, mounted electro-optical sight, which can do 360 degrees surveillance and reconnaissance while the tank is in totally undercover. The sight is with thermal day sight with long range capability and a laser range finder on a stabilized optical bench. Coupled with it, Altay has a laser warning device in 360 degrees, but in this there is also a turntable soft kill mechanism, which can fire two salvos of multispectral grenades so that it conceals any laser homing missile. Additionally, we have a fire detection radar, jammer, which is coupled with the surveillance and survivability kit of the tank. Here in Altay variant, the commander has remote control weapon station, which can be slaved to the gunner, and both electro-optical sight and the remote control weapon station is manned by the commander. I think this type of configuration gives a high survivability in asymmetrical threats in an urban environment. Altay's main armament is 120 millimeter smoothbore main gun. This is a NATO standard and it fires NATO standard ammunition. The gun itself is coupled with 7.62 coaxial machine gun as well. The gun is developed by company MKK in Turkey, and during the firing trials for first round probability studies, we fired lots of different ammunitions with different, under different scenarios, day and night. So the gun has a very nice range. The caliber is L55, so it's a long range gun used nowadays in modern NATO armies. And it's coupled with a fire control system, which can be also used by the commander as well. So commander, with his true panoramic sight, can see all around, and it has a hunter and killer capability, and it is, when required, can be used by the commander. On top of the gun, there is an IFF interrogator and responder, so during firing you can check the IFF facility as well. Here we see the rear engine compartment of Altay. The engine is 1500 horsepower MTU coupled with rank transmission, so it is a good package for Altay. and it's a part of European power pack solution. The cooling system in Altay is a heavy duty cooling system which can give a good performance without torque truncation of the engine in very high ambient temperatures. Coupled with it also, I can tell you that it's one of the high air filtration system, very precise and fine air filtration system, which makes a good performance under very dusty or sandy conditions. Here you can also see a part of the urban survival kit with slate armor for the engine compartment, which is efficient for the shoulder-fired weapons, which provides a high probability of protection on the areas where there is no personnel but rearwards of the tank. With this configuration, we evaluate that Altay is a very cost-effective and highly performing solution for Turkish Army, but it also is a good proposal for any army which requires a high performance and at a cost-effective price. So Altay provides a good and a feasible product, high-performing product for our export markets as well.